organization of this workshop, I chose this poem and a few others to memorize and recite for a small audience. And it was quite a discovery for me. It felt like almost like a sort of coming home in an area that most people would call a no man's land, between somewhere between literature or poetry on the one hand and music on the other hand. But I was inspired, and I went looking for other materials, maybe I could just briefly show a few early sound poems from the turn of the 8th and the 19th and 20th century. That's one by a German poet, Paul Schierbart, who published a few nonsense poems in a book of otherwise poems in German. And contemporary was Christian Morgenstern, also in a book with German poetry. He published a few nonsense poems, Das große Lalola, the great Lalola, with a repeated line, Lalo, 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 La. And his most famous poem is this one. It's entitled The Night Song of the Fish, and it's quite a challenge to put this into sound, but my favorite interpretation is like this. Like the opening closing of the mouth of the fish, it's almost no sound. And this is another one by Hugo Ball. That's another one of his caravan. And then this one is by Raoul Hausmann, who this is from 1919, a friend of Kurt Schwitters, the author of the piece that I will present as a second set tonight, the Ur Sonata, or Primordial Sonata, Sonata in Primitive Sounds. And this was a poster poem about this size. He had access to a print shop where he could use the letters that had been discarded because they were damaged or worn out. So that's why there's all the different fonts and sizes mixed up. Another poster poem of his, or two of them, one read, Pegif, and another one that Pegif Mu. Those were the lines that Kurt Schwitters was very excited about and sort of formed into the beginning of his sonata that he started in 1922. The first theme, the beginning is Fims Bovetetse U Pegif Mie. So those lines came actually from his friend Raoul Hausmann. This is work by Theo van Doesburg, another friend of Kurt Schwitters, more known as a visual artist and founder of the movement and magazine Bestel. These are called letter klankbeelden, or letter sound images. With in the bottom instruction how to read, and he also published some more elaborate instructions on how to read these poems. And this is one from 1924 by Man Ray, the French photographer and filmmaker. This always struck me as a sort of a rather aggressive act of censorship, crossing out the whole poem to make it unreadable. So my version of this goes also with a fairly aggressive sound, like and so on, a whole poem with the sounds, the durations relative to the length of these strokes. There's a recording on the internet if you like listening to it. It's about 7.5 minutes duration. So I found this sonata by Schwitters in 1979. copies of it at the Institute for German Language in Utrecht, where I was living at the time at the university. And I had no intention in the beginning to be a performer of that piece, but it was such fun to practice sections of it that I took it out every once in a while, and after maybe 2.5-3 years, I noticed that I almost knew the whole thing by heart, and I was asked by a friend to present it, perform it on his birthday party. And people liked it, and then I was invited to a neighborhood bar, and so it went rolling. And these performances were like in the early 1980s, and often it was like in punk rock clubs, where people came to listen to their favorite music, favorite bands, or either to just chat with each other and have a beer, and not to listen to this kind of nonsense. So they ended up throwing the beer at me. I think some of you may have read the interview I did for the Roulette website. And but for me it was a good way to start as a performer, because I felt the Swedish piece was a piece that deserved to be presented and to be defended, even against hostile audiences. So I always recited it towards the end. It's about a half-hour piece. And I think it made it sort of easier. If I would have started out in those circumstances with my own work, I might have gotten some doubts. Should I continue with this? But this piece is such a masterpiece that it helped me